You never killed a woman before, did you? And you don't need to do it. Mance would take you. I know he would. Oh, there's secret ways. Your brothers desert you. I can tell you which way to go. There's no shelter here.
There's no shelter anywhere.
There is. If you know where to look. I could teach you how to do it.
I know how to do it.
You know nothing, Jon Snow.
Totally, totally. And I think even when I kind of like arrived as a newbie, particularly in Game of Thrones, I was, yeah, unaware of the phenomenon that it would become. I mean, it's amazing to have been a part of both those shows.
So where is this accent from, the real you?
So the real me right now, this is, this is the accent that I've always had.
So where are you from?
I'm, bizarrely enough, I'm actually from Scotland.
Oh. No!
Yeah, right. So that is my home. That was where I was born and raised. Mm-hmm. And that's where my parents still live.
So like, why no Scottish accent then?
I was sent to not drama school, but boarding school in Somerset.
Yes.
Bezies agirigle.
Scorosso jevibrosa.
Torconudo.
Torconudo.
One boy is scared of dogs. One boy hates high places. One is frightened of the ocean. They make the boy sleep with dogs or climb a cliff. They throw him in the water.
It's a very exciting season. It's full of surprises, full of drama, and just beautifully written, as always. And it looks amazing. I think there's going to be things in this season that people haven't seen on TV before. And I'm
Hold on.
Help Bran down the hall.
Hold on.
Go back and find your clothes, Hold on. Go dress.
Hold on. Hold on!
Quiet, Hold on.
Hold on!
Make him shut up if they hear us.
Hush, Hold on. No more Hold on.
Hold on! Hold on!
Hold on, calm down.
Hold on!
I want an egg. How'd you like them? Boiled? Fried up with some butter?
Hold on.
With a rasher of bacon and some blood sausage.
Hold on.
During the filming of season one of Game of Thrones, I unfortunately had a nude scene to do. I had a huge prosthetic penis strapped onto me in a very, very uncomfortable way. The pubic hair was plaited into my own pubic hair and glued. So for weeks later, I would be finding pieces of prosthetic penis attached to my own. I was promised it would be a closed set, which is where there's like five people, only the necessary people. I arrived on the set and there was like 200 people.
You are the king's hand and the king is a fool. Your friend I know, but a fool, and doomed unless you save him.
He gave me a potion that made me powerless to move or speak, yet did nothing to dull my senses. With a hooked blade, he sliced me, root and stem, chanting all the while.
The Seven Kingdoms need someone stronger than Tommen, but gentler than Stannis. A monarch who can intimidate the High Lords and inspire the people. A ruler loved by millions with a powerful army and the right family name.
Absolutely life-changing in so many ways. The fact that I remember doing my first show on Broadway in 2000 and somebody giving me a box set of The Sopranos and that White Noise logo at the beginning, and I just thought, oh, I'd love to do something like this, but I'd have to leave home. I'd have to go to across the other side of the world, and they came to me. So the lesson is, if you wait long enough, right?
Because they shoot
it in an hour away from where I grew up and live.
Are you completely mad?
He saw us.
It's all right.
He saw us.
I heard you the first time.
Robert Baratheon marched from the capital after his victory at the Trident. But my father arrived first. The whole Lannister army at his back, promising to defend the city against the rebels.
Cersei had several ideas, whipping you through the streets and beheading you in front of the Red Keep.
flaying you alive and hanging you from the walls of King's Landing.
Jeg tænker jo aldrig på, jeg tænker jo ikke Jamie som ond eller ond eller god. Jeg tænker jo ikke sådan på karaktererne. Jeg tænker man prøver altid at forstå, hvorfor handler de som de gør. Hmm. Det samme i den her film, der spiller jeg jo faktisk to roller. Jeg spiller også en
ja, du spiller jo en barne.
Ja, som i hvert fald gør noget meget diskutabelt, ikke?
Ja.
The funny thing is, you know, I don't believe in ghosts. I don't believe in that stuff, but at the same time there's that weird the fear of the unknown. I think we all have that. I think that's why why do you want to go to see a movie where you get really scared? I mean, but we like it.
A man, I didn't know his face. He came to ask if I'd testify against you. Said I'd be named Sir Podrick Payne if I told the judges you'd bought a poison called the Strangler.
What exactly did you do for Lord Tyrion?
I brought him his meals and cleared his table when he was finished. I kept his clothing and linens clean, carried his messages and returned the replies. Mostly I poured wine.
He keeps his nose clean, keeps his head down, and he doesn't piss too many people off. I've been on the show for about 5 years now, so you get used to it. You get used to it, and every year it gets easier to come in and come back out. But at the end of every season shooting, it is a surprise that it's not going to be there anymore for a little while. So it's, yeah.
Do you like games, little man? Let's play a game. Run to your brother.
I heard you two had been reunited. A fitting place for it. I like to imagine that the last time you spoke was in this very room. My lady, we are all a family, we Northerners. Our blood ties go back thousands of years. So I'd like to drink to our wedding.
And just in sort of, I don't even got a pre-devoid, probably getting Cavalry and getting it. And it's just Nessie and McKellen and Vinny Charlotte having that stuff all on. I'm really nice, I'm nothing navy team, I'm really good for this.
But I mean, I wasn't even allowed to say what my character was called until after episode 10 of season 3 came out, so you kind of get used to it, yeah. And there's a lot of questions and everyone's trying to get spoilers, but...
Pass the menu for my manners, pick the food to be a fool. You're a different kind of decoration, cause you wear the room. Bang, bang. Oh yeah, I looked across the room and you were looking back at me. Happy with heart instead of money, and my weakness was the tip. Bang, bang.
Right back to Lord Frey. Thank him for his service and command him to send Robb Stark's head. I'm going to serve it to Sansa at my wedding feast.
Champion's purse. Though, you're not the champion yet, are you? A true champion defeats all their challengers. Uncle! Where are you going? You're my cupbearer, remember?
I thought I might change out of these wet clothes, Your Grace.
No. You're perfect the way you are.
But perhaps we must more frequently tear ourselves away from the mystery and beauty of the starry heavens above, and rather inspect, admire, and foster the moral law within. I mean, it really comes down to just not kind of deriving as much enjoyment as I did from acting as I used to. You know, I started acting when I was 8 and really, really loved it, you know, and all I wanted to be was an actor when I grew up. But for some reason, I don't know, it became kind of a bit mechanical and less kind of passionate for me when I started Game of Thrones. I don't think it's got anything to do with the way they film it, but I think when it became less of a recreation and more of a profession, it kind of put more pressure on the acting itself and made it a tiny bit less enjoyable.
You've got an aunt in the Vale, a rich Aunt Lysa. After I sell you to her, maybe she'll have enough left over to buy you that pony you want so much.
Well, here you are.
Here I am. Bring me one of those chickens.
You got money to pay for it?
You paid for it.
So, you got money?
Not a penny. I'll still take that chicken.
I've heard that before. Man was talking about a different god, though.
Well, maybe he was right. I don't know much about the gods.
You're in the wrong line of work.
Our planet is beautiful, and so is our country.
but the threats we face have never been more serious. From climate change, flooding and deforestation, to waste, war and weapons of mass destruction.
And I'm in the middle of shooting so much that I'm actually wearing a fake beard. Because normally I have a face.
Now, Rory, I know you're not on social media, but have people at least come? I know, but what has been the reaction to you coming back? Obviously, people would have come up to you and.
Yeah, they're doing the thank God, and it's great now. I can stop lying now because I've just been going, I'm dead. All right, go away. But now I can start telling the truth now. So that's good. Yeah, and it's great to be back now. It's fantastic.
Me too, dear.
Death is so boring. Especially now, with so much excitement in the world. My lady, I'm sorry for your loss.
Rosalind caught a fine fat trout. Her brothers gave her a pair of wolf pelts for her wedding. Signed, Walder Frey.
I wouldn't say you're a prisoner on this island. You're free to walk the castle, the beaches, to go wherever you want.
Except to my ship. He took my ship.
I wouldn't say we took your ship.
I'm not playing word games with you.
You know, every time I live in New York, every time you sort of walk out your door, you get a reaction. But they're great. They're I love the fans of this genre, sci-fi, fantasy, whatever, comic book. They're really knowledgeable, which I love, which is helpful to me, because they know things I don't know about. The smallest detail of these characters, it's always positive, but it's hard to keep up with this changing world of the internet and all of that, because I'm pretty much a Luddite when it comes to that. I know how to play Words with Friends, and that's the extent of it. I look at my search history, and it's like Words with Friends and emailing. I wouldn't know how to explore the web too much.